I'm in the same area where I was a couple of vlogs ago. If you're a regular on the channel, you will know I was photographing roe deer. And then a hiker came walking through the fields with a dog, and the roe deer were gone. That was actually over there. But today, roe deer were over there. I wasn't even supposed to do any meaningful photography. You could see my clothes. I'm really I'm wearing my my all-stars, but I thought I will just bring my camera just in case. So I have my a7r4 with the 200 to 600. You never know what's going to pop up. I just wanted to do a walk over here because I haven't been here in a while, just to see what was going on. And then I saw the road here. Oh, so they were all the way in the other side of that field. And I thought, it's been a while I did a roe deer stalk for such a distance, because it's a couple of 100 meters, so that was quite something to do. But yeah, I thought, let's give it a go. So for the first 100 meters or so, I could simply walk and keep a good eye on them, because whenever they are with their hair down and they are feeding, it's pretty okay to move forward a couple of meters. But then, yeah, you need to wait, because when they're up with their head, then they can, yeah, they have good vision all around. So if I would be moving, they would see me, and that's that would spoil the rest of the the rest of the stalk. But that went pretty well, and I first thought it were two, but there was one further down, a male, a roe deer buck, lying in the grass as well. Oh, and it was beautiful. And you know what I really like, because the grass is really like a saturated green. Maybe it might look like this on the video, Jeroen, you pumped up the green. No, Jeroen didn't pump up the green. It is really that green. And the cool thing is that the roe deer have their summer fur right now. So, and it's really that rusty red orange. Oh, I really like that color. So, yeah, I thought, oh, this could turn out really nice. After a while, I did have to go down flat on the belly and crawl my way towards the deer. Well, that went pretty well. It turned out, I thought there was a a roe deer lying down in the grass as well. But that turned out to be a hare. I also thought the tips of the ears had black points and that didn't really fit the roe deer. So I was already thinking, that might be a hare. But that indeed turned out to be a hare. But that's actually quite cool in the same frame to have a roe deer and a hare. So. No complaints from me. Really cool. Really awesome. I was thinking if I would get all the way to that hedge where they were lying down, I could actually there's a hedge over here as well. If I would be all the way over here, then the hedge on the other side would be really far away. I would be able to make that really out of focus, but unfortunately, that still mean quite a bit of crawling. And it seems that some weather is coming in as well. I can actually, if I take a really good look, I can see stripes of rain falling down over there as well. But doesn't really matter, because in the end, the roe deer made the decision for me, because they stood up and they slowly walked to the edge of the forest. So I just, at that moment, I just decided I will just go down flat on my belly, wait until they are gone, so I wouldn't disturb anything, and then move back. Awesome evening. Love this. Great.